Scott Morrison is pushing hard to revive Gladys Berejiklian's career to try and win back a blue ribbon Sydney seat from an independent. But with the former Premier still under investigation by the corruption watchdog, Labor says it highlights the Prime Minister's lack of integrity.
Recycling is clearly on the Prime Minister's mind.
Australian remade.
And not just plastic.
I think this is a great opportunity if Gladys wishes to run, but again, that's up to her.
As he tries to jawbone the former New South Wales Premier Gladys Berejiklian out of retirement and into a federal election race.
If she wants to have a crack at Warringah for the Liberal Party, I suspect the people in Warringah would welcome that.
But Scott Morrison has to clear two big hurdles, convincing the former Premier to run and overcoming the fact that she is currently under investigation by the New South Wales Independent Commission Against Corruption over whether she breached public trust or ignored alleged corrupt behaviour by her ex-boyfriend and ex-state MP, Darryl Maguire.
Gladys was put in a position of actually having to stand down. And there was no findings of anything. Now, I don't call that justice.
The dismissal of the corruption watchdog plays to one of Labor's major themes.
Again goes to the Prime Minister's fundamental dishonesty. He defended Gladys Berejiklian by saying there'd been no finding against her. There had been no findings at all.
Warringah was a Liberal stronghold until it was lost by Tony Abbott to independent and former champion skier Zali Steggall at the last election.
3, 2, 1.
Tony Abbott's trouble in Warringah began at the 2016 election when his primary vote dropped over 9 percentage points. 3 years later, against Zali Steggall, it crashed another 12.6. If anyone can win the seat back for the Liberals, it would be Gladys Berejiklian.
Are you keen to enter politics again?
Zali Steggall says the push will blow back on the government.
This sends a really wrong message to the Australian people about what the level of integrity and where their compass is.
The Prime Minister is also keen to get voters to focus on the head-to-head contest between leaders.
And at the end of the day, someone's going to be chairing Cabinet, and that's going to be me or Anthony Albanese.
This is a bad government.
It always boils down to the same question. Who do you trust? Chris Yuleman, Nine News.
Chris O'Keefe joins me now in the studio. So, Chris, just how realistic is it that Gladys Berejiklian will return to politics?
Well, from all the conversations I've had today, Georgie, you would have to say it is only an outside chance at this point. I am told the Prime Minister and Gladys Berejiklian spoke last week where he asked her if she wanted to run, and she told him she would think about it. Now, Scott Morrison has even pushed back the deadline to give her more time. Plus, I'm told more polling was conducted over the weekend that shows the former Premier would overwhelmingly win the seat of Warringah and end Zali Steggall's political career. But Gladys Berejiklian's close allies in the state parliament think it is very unlikely she will accept the offer and instead wait for ICAC to be behind her and get a lucrative job outside of politics in the meantime. One thing we know about the former Premier, though, Georgie, nobody will rush her or pressure her into anything.
Time will tell. Thank you, Chris.